Listen, I think you'd agree with me in that criticism has been difficult, obviously, but it's also been one of the greatest blessings in the history of Fellowship Church, mm-hmm. because as we've learned, there's no opportunity without opposition, and the opposition simply alerts us to this incredible That's right. position that God's given us. So we've sort of lived in a state of tension for 20 years. In fact, mm-hmm. I don't know if we can remember even several months, I'm trying to think, in the history of Fellowship Church that we've not had some sort of, you know, negativity, whatever. But now it is on a different level. And I think the first real negative story from the media came out about us maybe 2001, 2002. Then we've had several other negative interactions. And recently we've had some negative publicity. And so much of it you know, in talking to my friends and pastors around the world now, because of social media, mm-hmm. we can communicate. Mm-hmm. So much of the negativity when it comes from the media occurs because of disgruntled former employees.
So that's where they get...
Well, a lot of it.
Yeah.
A lot of it is. And what's so funny, someone told me this recently. They said, you know, Ed, when you're paying these people, they're not negative.
Yeah,
but once they're released... So often that's when they get negative. And let me tell you this, and this is a huge learning about employees in the church. And Preston, you worked in the corporate world for mm-hmm. years and years and mm-hmm. years, a big corporation. Yep. I will not name, but
thank you.
One that's a monster. And you know, when someone would release someone back in the corporate world, it was not that big of a deal. Okay, this person's released, we're downsizing, whatever, it didn't work out, boom, it's over. In the church world, it's not that way.
No.
And you know this because you've had the opportunity, like I have, to release people. Mm-hmm. When you release people in the church world, Preston, it's like a divorce.
Yeah.
I mean, it is. It's like a divorce. And I've spoken with some attorneys who are in family law, and I'm telling you, it is like that because your emotions, mm-hmm. your family is involved, and many times when you fire someone, not all the time, but some of the time when you fire someone, check this out, they will start a fire and become an arsonist and try to burn, believe it or not, the only institution that Jesus ever built.
Right.
So, as a leader, you gotta understand it, and you've got to spray your life with fire retardant material, and you gotta walk through the fire. You gotta do what Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did. It's not easy.
Well, and I've heard you say many times, you don't read negative stuff.
I don't. I try not to.
You don't read positive stuff because I love how you say it. If you do that, your life is just up and down.
That's a great point.
And so tell pastors why you don't do that.
You know, Preston, if we rise and fall with negative or positive comments, it's really like the proverbial roller coaster is, they're saying good stuff about me. It's awesome. Then, boom. And that can happen. If you're reading a lot of letters, texts, emails from the church, or it can happen in the media, it can happen in a number of areas. So what I have tried to do, I've not done this perfectly, mm-hmm. whether we're on some show and people are saying, that's great, isn't, you know, God great, and isn't Fellowship Church great, or whatever, I try not to watch it or even read it. I mean, I might see a little bit of it, but that's it.
Mm-hmm.
The same is true when something is negative. I don't hyper-focus, because if you do, what'll happen is, I believe you'll shrink your vision and you'll only think about trying to convince that negative person or that negative reporter or negative station or whatever. And we're not gonna change negative people. I'll repeat, you're not gonna come out with some blog or some sermon or some whatever to change them. Only God can do that. So once you figure that out, you're not going to waste time chasing and running down all those things. I go back to it, an audience of one.
That's right.
When I played ball at Florida State, you know, I sat the bench most of the time. You've heard me say this mm-hmm. so often, but I did start a couple of games, and one of the games I started was against Auburn. My father flew in to watch me play. And there were 16,000 people there. And you know what? I was only thinking about him.
That's
I didn't give a flying flip about the 15,999. I only thought about him.
That's right.
And at the end of the day, guys, that is what we're playing for. We're mm-hmm. playing for an audience of one. the other stuff hurts. It hurts to get criticism. Preston, you've been on the brunt of the receiving end of it. So have I. So have everybody watching me. And that's okay. But I'm telling you, the ministry, if you're called to it, which you are, which I am, is the most beautiful thing in the world. But also there's a brutal side to it. And I call it the brutal, the brutal life.
Right.
So it shouldn't be a deal like where we're going, oh no, the other foot's getting ready to come down. Right. Oh no, oh wow, lions, tigers, bears, ah! You know, we can't do that. But we have to realize, okay, it's gonna happen, it's inevitable, and it's part of it.
Well, I heard you say something I thought was astounding, because I never thought about it, but you said, we need to hang around the people who appreciate what we do.
That's right.
And appreciate
celebrate
the power
appreciate.
Of the gospel.
Yes.
Yeah, and all that
stuff. Yeah.
And let's just face it, the media does not appreciate what we do.
Yeah, people, Preston, by and large, and this is not true for all the media, there are some amazing people in the media.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.
There are.
We have some in our church.
Mm-hmm.
But a number of people in the media, let's face it, they don't value what we do. And because they don't value what we do, they take shots and make comments and deal with exaggerations and half-truths, and they team up with the former employees and other people, and they try to tear down what God has done. And that's just part of it.
That's just
part of the deal. So what I say is, you know, understand it. Know that's what you're dealing with. Pray and stay above the fray, and God will take you places you never dreamed possible. I, though, believe that every time in our 20-year history that we've received criticism from within the church, also from without the church,
it's
taken us to another level, and it's galvanized our church. And just recently, you know, we've had some negative stuff, really since about 2001. We've had two or three things, and recently we've had some stuff, and it's galvanized our church.
Yes.
It's literally helped our church. It's bonded our church. It's not easy to go through the stuff, because when you walk around, you think everybody's thinking about Fellowship Church, or everybody's thinking about me or whatever.
Right.
But it's not, you know, it's not true. We have a tendency to exaggerate and to blow those things up.
Well, and you're right. It does. It's like the wheat and the tares. When you have controversy and something negative, you see who's really got your back and who trusts you. And it's okay if those people want to leave, because they need to. So it kind of brings the light onto people who probably even shouldn't be a part of your church.
Yes.
And if they leave, that's fine. Don't freak out about that.
Right. And Preston, you've done such a great job over the years of telling people over the years, not in a mean way, but you were the first person I've ever seen, ever, to just say in a real way, hey, you know what? Our church is not for everybody. Maybe it's not for you. Why don't you go to another church? And I think that's a freeing thing, Preston, because you were even doing that before you were a hired gun here.
Right, right.
Okay? I think it's a freeing thing to tell people, hey, you know what? If this is not for you, go somewhere else.
That's right. Life's too short to mess with stuff like that.
Yes, it is.